my name is George Lucas. They've asked me to tell you a bit about how I made the Space Films series. I started it because I needed the money, quite frankly, when I wrote Space Film 1. Now, one of the cleverest ideas I ever came up with was putting a desert in space. No one had ever thought about that before, because of course everyone always thinks of space as a dark, cold place and that. So I thought, oh, hang on a minute, why don't we fuck around with that and stick a desert up there? So we had to go out to Tunisia to film it, see? And these first scenes were with the fucking robots. Now, there was the twatty one, and then there was the little cunt. I forget their names. But anyway, the little one, throughout this time in Tunisia, I felt for him, because the poor cunt was sweating his bollocks off all the way through filming inside the sort of tin can we got him in, right? He turned up on the first day. We stuck him inside the thing. It's like a fucking dustbin we'd painted. And he was livid about it, to be fair. But I said to him, I said, look, mate, you knew what you were getting into when you signed up for this job. If you didn't know about a robot costume, take it up with your fucking agent, as far as I'm concerned. Of course, this was before the little people got all unionised properly, so there was not much he could do about it. So in he went. Now, one thing that always bothered me about that whole situation, we had this little geezer in the tin can in 40 degree fucking heat. He didn't make the bleeping noises that the robot made, because we added them on after, you know, sound effects in the edit. And he didn't have to move the thing about, because we had it on a set of wheels and we were pulling it along by the old prop men. So he didn't make the noises. He didn't move it. You didn't see him. So you've got to ask yourself, haven't you? Why the fuck did we have anyone in there at all? So anyway, we finished the film, Space Film 1. It is what it is. A few months later, I was in the middle of packing up for a move out to Spain. My missus had a sister living out in the Costa Brava at the time in a lovely resort called Lorette du Mar. The wife was fucking obsessed with us getting out there to live too. So anyway, the phone rings as we're packing for the airport, and it's the fucking studio. I thought, fuck me, they want their money back. The film's a piece of shit. They fucking clocked it. Anyway, as it turns out, not only did the studio not want their money back, but the film had been a massive fucking hit and they wanted a sequel. So we've had to press pause on the old Lorette du Mar thing and knock out a Space Film 2. Now, this time I thought, how can I give it a twist? So, bang, it's hit me. Instead of setting it in the desert, I'll set it in the snow. Partly, to be honest, because I felt sorry for the little geezer in the tin can playing the robot. I mean, I thought another month in the desert would finish the cunt off. So, I turn out the second film in the snow. Even fucking bigger than the first one. Before you know it, the studio are back on the blower, asking for Space Film 3. Now, I'd lost interest by this stage. I mean, how many stories about a bunch of daft cunts up in space fighting with electric swords can one bloke come up with? But I had a situation out at the new rig in Lorette du Mar. We'd got out for the final meeting, and it comes to my attention that the gaff we're buying next door to her sister's has a serious fucking plumbing problem. Cut a long story short, you had to put your used bog roll in the bin next to the carsy. The pipes were too fucking narrow to accommodate your shitty paper. Anyway, I've had to get a major plumbing job done on the place with proper wide pipes fitted. It weren't cheap. Until then, some dozy cunt up from the village would come twice a week with his fucking donkey and cart to collect all your shitty paper and put it in landfill. Well, the plumbing job weren't going to be cheap, so it was with that in mind that I agreed to Space Film 3. But I had a problem. I'd run out of ideas, hadn't I? So I've dug out these drawings that I've been mucking about with in my old ideas, but, you know, little fucking teddy bears, right? Walking, talking teddy bears, but they all had catapults and that, right? I got them biked over to the studio, and they seemed to like them. So I thought, bang, there you go. Run with it, lads. No, they want more. All right, how about the space princess character? She's very popular. I forget her name. Lovely girl. Beautiful figure. But the problem was, in the first couple of movies, you never got to see the figure because she was always wearing, your space robes, right? Covered her up. So I tell the studio, how about we put her in a fucking space bikini in the new film? They said, fine, George, you got any drawings? Now, I didn't have drawings, and I'll tell you as to why. I consider myself a creative fella, but funny thing about me is I could never draw birds. So anyway, what I did was I cut this picture out of the Kay's catalogue of a lovely Doris in a bikini. I send it over to them at the studio with a note saying, imagine this, but in gold and up in space. Now, they liked it, but were they satisfied? Were they fucked? They're back on the blower the next day, asking for more ideas. So I've said to them, all right, how about this? Bang, big fucking space slug. I envisaged a space princess in her bikini, chained up to this big fat cunt. It's unclear whether the cunt's got a cock or not, but we will give every indication that he probably has. You can't see it, mind you, because it'll be hidden underneath all his rolls of fat and that. So you ain't sure if he's got a lob on. But he probably fucking has, the way the princess looks in this bikini. And I says to the bloke at the studio, when you see her, you'll have a lob on as well, you cunt. Bang! Conversation over. Now, the plumbing bill, meanwhile, kept going up and up over in Spain. And I'm not being racist, but I tell you, Spanish plumbers are every bit as fucking slow and lazy as you might imagine. So with that in mind, I thought we better start knocking out a load of plastic figures sharpish so I can make what I need to pay the plumbers and shut my moaning wife up. Well, anyway, Space Film 3, massive smash hit, weren't it? And that was it. Bang. I'm out in Spain with my own fucking pool, nice, modern, properly plumbed toilet that I could shit into in peace. TTFN, I thought. That's me, retired happily under the Spanish sun. Unfortunately, though, things didn't work out how I might have liked in Spain. My first wife, well, she was a complicated woman. Marriages are complex things, and when they break down, it's always difficult to pinpoint any one thing that caused it. But I will say that this was a woman who failed to wake me up during Match of the Day on three consecutive Saturday nights. I mean, I remember the third time it happened. I woke up from a deep fucking sleep, and the first thing I've seen is we're halfway through Stoke fucking Swansea City, the last game on the programme. I mean, that was it for me. I packed my bags that night. I was gone on the first fucking flight the next morning, back to Hollywood, which is how I ended up making all them fucking prequels with the racist aliens a few years later. But that's another story for another time. Anyway, there you go. That's basically how I made the first three space films. Thanks for listening. God bless and be lucky.
This is it.